Hey, bitch talkers. This is episode 221 of the Bitch Talk Podcast. Let's do a little maintenance first. You can find us at Facebook at Bitch Talk Podcast. You can find us on Twitter at Bitch Talk Pod. You can find us on Instagram. It's Bitch Talk Podcast, one word. And you can email us. It's therealbtpod@gmail.com. The final thing I need to announce is our website is brand spanking new. Our logo is brand spanking new and beautiful by friend of the show and of our documentary.
Friend of life.
Friend of my life, Justine Young. Thank you, Justine. I've already got compliments from our friend in Canada, Angela To Be Pecked.
What?
She tweeted at me right away when I changed everything. She's like, oh my God, this looks classy. It's great. Did you already update Facebook? How about the website? So she's on top of
wow,
it.
Wow, we need to go to Canada and hang
I'm
out
down.
With her.
I mean,
she's
we may
awesome.
Have to go to Canada.
She's awesome.
Yeah.
Should we ask Erin Christine what she thinks of her?
I don't know. Can you? Because I am done razzing Erin Christine. I love you, girl. I'm sending you a shout out right now. Angela
well,
and I have had
I
a
never
chat.
Meant any harm, Miss Erin Christine. We're just poking fun and
wait,
we thought it was
bitch
funny.
Talk. You've heard us before. We
will. I'm going to be in Reno on Sunday, so.
Oh, of course you will. I mean, well, oh, yeah, it is your birthday. I forgot.
Well, no, but we have to wait till we're all there. It has to 40, be the trifecta.
Sure.
But no, we didn't mean to make fun of you if you took it that way. I'm sorry. It was a funny situation. We had to talk about
we
it.
We have been talking about going to Reno forever.
Yeah,
and we finally did, and we're really excited to meet you.
Erin Christine, if you're out there, please come back. We
come
miss
back.
You.
Just come back. We need you. We need you.
It's we okay love if you're afraid of us.
Well, I don't know about need. You don't want to scare her again.
No,
we don't need you, but
look,
we would
we
like for you
to. We
need
that Reno connection. I mean, we have it with Char, obviously. But Erin Christine really, like, nudged us. That's all I'm going to say. So,
yeah.
Anyways, moving on.
We're at
a place called
Frankenry Images.
Frankenry Images. I'm sorry. Didn't know what we were getting into.
San Francisco artist, and this is her space. It's like her gallery, her home, and it is
amazing.
So magical.
It's like if you walked in. I don't even know how to explain this place. It's like if you walked into a set, really, like a Hollywood set.
Yeah, there's bits and pieces from just about anything. We have to take a bunch of pictures and put it on.
I don't think pictures are going to do it justice.
It won't.
And I
kind of
want to keep
it. It's kind of the feel. It's more about the feel.
I want to keep it a secret a little bit. A mystery, really.
It is
right?
A mystery.
Right, Char?
Yeah.
Are you ready to squat here with me?
I don't know.
You
about
can have a room up front. I'll have this
room. It is very close
to everything we need.
Yes, exactly.
Ballpark.
We can walk to the studio from
studio.
Here.
Studio. I mean,
bridge,
what else do you want?
Everything.
Bridge is right here.
I was like, oh, this is going to be so easy to get to where I need to go.
To do everything we need to do.
21st Amendment
in our life.
Yes.
Sure.
It's a house. Slice House.
Oh, Slice House, yeah.
Anyway, I'm extremely excited to talk to co-authors of this incredible
yeah,
book.
Yeah, I'm sorry. We're here because, duh, we got invited to the Hot Mess Kitchen book event, which is with our friend Gabby Moskowitz. She's been on the show a couple times. She's the Broke-Ass Gourmet. And then new to the cookbook scene, her name's Miranda Berman. She's actually a comedy writer, you guys. I think she was part of a thing called The Mindy Project. You
no
want to Google
deal.
That?
No big deal.
NBD. NBD.
Yeah.
Doesn't
fucking
matter.
Fucking hilarious.
Yeah, she's hilarious. And then I think we might have a special guest as well. So stay tuned. Who you haven't heard from since before she got engaged to some guy. Her roommate. Her roommate.
Episode.
Oh,
I don't know.
God.
Look in October of 2015.
That's is when that when it was?
When
wow.
I mean,
memory,
Char. You're about to turn 40, and that is like
well, that's because, you know, she was about to move to Houston at the time because the season
oh,
was
true.
Over.
Oh, true. You're right. You're
and
right.
And they were going to Disneyland for her birthday.
Walt Disney World.
Or, no, Walt Disney World.
But she hadn't been yet. Plus, there was Harry Potter World.
And then everything exploded, and we were just saying it's like we had talked about doing a bunch of stuff together
oh, yeah.
and all that, and it's just like
and now
all of a sudden, you know,
the end of 2017.
Life happens. It's the end of 2017, and
yeah,
it's but time for the move again because she has to do it yearly.
Yeah, I couldn't do that. Cheers to you, special guest. but yeah, we're having a great time, and we're really, really, really thankful and appreciative of Gabby and Miranda having us here at their special event. It's their last event in San Francisco. They will be in D.C. and in New York promoting this book. Please go see them. Buy the book. This would be a great holiday gift, guys.
Yeah,
you
no
know,
shit.
Whatever you're celebrating at the end of the year, buy this book. Give it to a friend. and enjoy our interviews. I think they're fun. Right, Ange?
Right.
Hey, Bitch Talkers. We are coming to you live from probably one of the most amazing little... I don't even know what to call this.
It's a secret hidden gem. Yeah, it's like a Alice in Wonderland.
Room. I don't want to tell anyone about it. I don't want them to be here ever because I'm going to squat here right after this party that we're at. The party that we are at is for the Hot Mess Cookbook from Gabby Moskowitz, who you might remember. She's been on the show a couple times. She's the Broke Ass Gourmet and new maybe to the cookbook scene. I think her name's Miranda Berman. She is here also tonight. But we bumped into an old friend of ours.
Friend of the show.
Just walking in, cute shoes with a friend. Her name's Lexi Pence. I mean, you may or may not know her. She's just a girl about town.
I just happened to stroll on in.
Yeah.
You smelled the food and you came on in.
Yeah. You just knocked on the green door and you're like, this is it.
Yeah. And then I came in and I ate. I put like 5 slices of pizza on my plate.
Yeah.
And I was like, this is so good.
It was delicious.
Yeah.
It shouldn't even be called pizza. There should be another name for that because it's different.
Well, I had a cauliflower crust, and I was like, I didn't even notice.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
That's what it is.
I didn't even notice.
Are you going to work that into your repertoire of cooking now?
Yeah.
Okay.
I was really impressed. I didn't even notice.
I didn't either.
Good.
I knew something was different, but I couldn't understand. And it's crispy.
It was
like, it's
crispy.
Cauliflower, and it's crispy.
Lexi.
But hi. Yeah, hi.
I mean, I will talk about the food all night long.
Yeah.
But how are you?
I'm good.
Last time you came on the show... There was a trip you were going to go on to Walt Disney World. You'd never been. Your roommate.
Oh my God, it's been so long.
Your roommate at the time was kind of like doing something special.
Yeah.
And, you know, blah, blah, blah. And then you engaged.
I did.
We're like, hot damn. Yes.
I had no idea, you guys.
Really? You really didn't?
I had no idea.
All right.
If you saw the video on my YouTube.
I think I did.
I would have picked a totally different outfit.
Wait, I think it was after a long day, right?
We were at the park all day. I didn't even shower. My nails were painted gray. I don't know why I thought that was a good idea at any point ever.
But if you're
at
Disney
love
World,
nails. Stop it.
You're not going to be all fashionable
at
Disney
ratty,
World,
you're
though.
Oh, really dirty.
Well, okay. Yeah.
So you kind of have to be on top of that.
Wow.
Which I was not. So, and we were running late for dinner, and I just didn't have time to, like, shower and, like, do my hair and... be cute, and
but
I was like, you know what, whatever, I'll just wear jeans, and it's just an,
it was cute the way it was
dinner.
You didn't know
it was he was perfect.
Yeah,
he did
that's
everything
more
perfectly.
Authentic.
Was he nervous, or did he tell you later? Was he like,
yeah, he said he was really nervous because he had the ring in his pocket, and so he was kind of like, oh my gosh, if she sees like a big bulge, you know, so he was trying to like avoid any like Lex to butt contact.
I'm gonna leave that one alone.
Yeah, we'll leave that alone. Yeah. That's what she said. Sorry, go ahead. Sorry. It's called bitch talk. Anyways.
But yeah, so he said he was nervous. And then when I was quickly like getting ready and like freshening up my face, I was like, put on music. I move faster to Beyonce.
Oh.
But he puts on like Faith Hill, like I Can Feel You Breathe, that song, like all these like romantic songs.
Whoa.
And I was like, babe, I said like, Beyonce,
yeah.
Not Faith Hill. Like,
yeah.
Love. I'm like, this is a weird getting ready song. It's like,
yeah, that's an unwinding kind of song.
So I didn't realize where his mind was at versus where my mind was at.
Back to the ring. Was he, sorry, you said he was carrying it around all day?
No, just at dinner.
Wow. Yeah. I'd be nervous all day
just
long.
Just like from the room to dinner.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not on the rides.
Not on the rides.
Okay. Thank goodness. So you guys got married.
We got married.
How was that shindig? I've heard stories from friends of ours. I heard it was awesome.
It was. I mean, I thought it was awesome, but I'm a little biased.
Yes. I heard there was a bus ride to Oakland, right?
Yes, we got married in Oakland.
Yes.
And then we had the reception here in the city at Epic Steakhouse.
Yes.
And it was the best day of my life.
I heard it was like people had their spirit animals.
Yeah, so we had everyone submit like a selfie of themselves, and we have this like spirit animal reader.
Love
she has like
it.
All the guys in the clubhouse. It's like a team thing. And
oh, that's
so
cool.
She just looks at your eyes and she tells you what your spirit animal is. And so we had all our guests submit a picture, and then she read everyone's spirit animals, and we gave like the description, and that's how you found your table.
What are you?
I'm a deer.
Are you?
Yeah.
Oh, I can see that. Yeah. But not the one that gets hit.
No.
By a
probably.
Car. The one
no,
that's
no,
like
no, no, no,
at
no,
some
no.
point in my life,
no,
probably.
No, you're drinking from a creek.
Yeah,
and you're
frolicking.
Like, oh, come on.
By a babbling brook.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Sure, okay. I like it.
Not on the side of a highway.
Side, or like the weird ones.
Not
with
the one that I cuss at.
No,
slam on my
yeah.
Face.
No raping.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Not like one of those weird ones.
No, you got your shots. You're fine.
Yeah, I'm,
yeah, yeah. Okay. You're domesticated.
Thank you, thank you.
That is awesome.
Yeah,
is
thanks.
She local? Can we have her?
I know.
I'll send you the email. She has like a website now set up. So
oh my God,
she's
you guys.
Super cool.
Maybe our next live event.
Yes.
Ooh. Yeah.
Sorry, I'm really excited.
She's amazing. Like, just talking to her, you're like, tell me more about myself.
Right. Yeah, yeah. Tell me more. Well, what animal?
Anne thinks her spirit animal is an old black man.
Okay. Anyways.
It might be. It might be.
Anyways. thanks, Ange. I haven't had enough booze for this interview yet, apparently. So what have you been up to this whole 2017 season, this year?
Well,
we know that one of your best friends moved away, who's also a friend of the show, Aaron Dolan, which was real. I mean,
is
that's
it weird
a real
like
bummer.
Teary-eyed just like thinking about it.
I'm not her best friend, and I was teary-eyed.
She's like the salt of the earth, Aaron.
Yes.
Like, she's so amazing.
I agree.
Yeah, so I was really sad, but I'm really happy for Sean.
Yes,
because you know they're in the postseason.
The Nationals
and this is
are
the
doing
first
well.
Time he's ever been there, so
right.
I'm like so excited for them, and like I want them to go all the way, because I love Sean and Aaron so much,
right.
And I'm like, this is amazing, so
right.
I'm really rooting for them.
Oh,
but I am sad.
I know. You guys live in the same building, right?
Yeah,
I mean, you guys were neighbors.
Yeah, she's just awesome. Like, we didn't see each other a whole lot because our schedules were flipped,
right?
But we text it all the time, and like, we just had so much in common. And
is she adjusting? Do you know? Or
yeah, she loves it out there.
Okay. All
yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
All right. Well, so, she's close to politics out there, which
exactly,
is right up her
exactly.
alley.
So they're good, and they're planning their wedding now.
Oh,
so
that's
they're,
right. They're engaged.
Yeah,
oh my God.
They're married in January in Chicago. So,
oh,
yeah.
Chicago.
Chicago.
A little deep dish.
Say it that way. I don't know why.
Are you yeah. already mapping out your coffee spots in Chicago, or do you already have them?
I already have some.
Ah,
yeah.
Which ones?
Ipsento is like my favorite there. They have okay. this amazing coffee that they compete with, and it's like a specialty drink, and they put cayenne pepper in it, which I would never
ooh.
Imagine would taste that good.
And yes. it does.
It's amazing. It's like a latte cappuccino with like a little kick of cayenne.
Mm.
And it's delicious. Ipsento. There's like two or three locations in Chicago.
Okay.
So if you're there, check it out.
Cayenne pepper?
Yeah. It's like a nice little kick.
Is this going to be your guys' retirement thing? Coffee, maybe?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
I mean, we're opening up a coffee shop.
What? No, I didn't know that.
Oh,
what?
You didn't know
no.
that? Yeah, we're opening up a coffee shop in Houston. And we're
oh.
doing coffee mixed with like new media. So if anyone wants to start a podcast or a vlog or stream,
okay.
or just come and play video games or board games,
sure,
it will have all of that. So it's a coffee shop mixed with new media and video games.
Wow,
like,
what's it called? Yeah,
all our passions in one place.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure Hunter built it just so I would stop complaining about nothing to do in Houston.
He's like, here.
Yeah.
This is yours.
Like, let me create a space for you to just go and do your thing.
Right.
With two of your passions, or all three of my passions, video games, new
right,
media,
under
and
one
coffee.
Roof.
Yeah. So, but it opens at the end of this year, and it's called Coral Sword.
What's it called?
Coral Sword.
Okay.
Which is a weapon from Final Fantasy.
I was wondering, I'm like, I know that's not
that's
from
gotta
Game of Thrones.
That's got to be a reference.
Yeah.
So
I knew that one. Yeah. Checked it off. That is awesome.
Yeah, thanks.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're
yeah,
welcome.
We're super excited.
You're coming up in the world, Lexi Pence.
Slowly but surely, you know? Slowly but surely. Yeah, we're getting there.
How is Houston doing? Side note. I mean, I feel like there's so much news every day of our lives right now that
so
I cannot catch up and... I don't know. I can't catch up. So tell
it's
me.
Hard. Well, we were lucky enough. All our friends and family barely got hit. So we were super lucky.
Right.
Wow.
But 27,000 homes were destroyed. And I mean, they still need a ton of money to repair and get people. I know the government is going in and buying homes to help people kind of, you know, move and find a new home and all that stuff. But that's still like a lot of trauma for people to have.
Yeah.
You know, you're talking family photos. Heirlooms,
yep.
you know, completely destroyed. And the city of Houston has a lot of work to do in terms of fixing their draining system and their reservoirs
right.
and all that stuff. So hopefully, you know, hopefully they step up and they figure it out. But a lot of the land there is owned by developers. So it's kind of like, you know, hopefully they find some ethical reason to, or you know, inspiration to be moved to kind of want to invest in their right. in their city and their community.
Right. And your shop fared okay? It's fine?
It's fine, yeah. Like I said, we got super lucky.
Okay.
Yeah, because we're a little bit north of where it really, really hit hard.
Okay.
So we got really lucky. But we're going to go back this off season, do a lot of work, volunteer work, help people kind of get back on their feet. It was hard.
Awesome.
It was hard to be here
of course.
And have that happen. I wasn't even in the country. So it was like even harder. So I was in Costa Rica for my aunt's wedding, and Hunter was traveling. I don't even know what city he was in.
Right.
But, you know, everyone's like flights got all delayed, and it was just a mess traveling because, you right. know, the airport was shut down. But, you know, we're hoping to go back and really put some love into the community and help out as much as we can in the off season.
Because that's what you do. You do that anyways.
You have to do that yeah. for your neighbors. You yep. know, mm-hmm. it's super important that, especially now, I feel like in this, where we're at in the country, mm-hmm. you know, there's such a divide. And I think people need to concentrate on, okay, we have freedom. We have all these wonderful things. Let's just concentrate on that. And let's try to make that part better.
Right.
You know?
Right.
I know there's a lot of negative. There's a lot of stuff going on. And it can be really scary.
Yeah.
Really scary.
We talk about it all the time.
Yeah.
When
yeah
talk.
It's really scary.
Trying
right
to, like, navigate through it.
Yeah.
And also, I think for Aunt Angela and I, we always look for the smaller things, like, to help out.
Yeah.
Because I think it's more of the smaller things
totally.
That help versus looking at the big picture. You can always just help
but the
your
big
neighbor.
Picture,
yeah, things locally.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Things locally. Your local yeah. government or local
totally.
Organizations. And
yeah. Just saying hi to your neighbor is like,
yeah.
that's huge.
Yeah.
Right? Like,
bring them sugar.
Yeah.
Being
seriously.
A good human
I have a really crazy story. So our building, we have three other neighbors, right?
Okay.
And we knew one of them from just like meeting them in the elevator. And then the other two, one of them is like always, I guess, out of town traveling. We always see his newspapers travel up. But I just thought our actual next door neighbor just didn't live there. I just thought no one lived there and it was like up for sale or whatever. And then finally someone told me, like, because I asked about it, I was like, hey, does anyone live in that apartment or like is it being sold or what's the deal? And they're like, no, an older lady lives there or an elder lady
sure.
lives there. And I was like, no, because I never see her blinds up. I never see, like, I can kind of, like, peek in, but her blinds are always down. And I was like, what?
Right.
And I literally just found this out, like, 2 days ago. I was like, someone lives there, and I had no idea. Here
wow.
I am making my videos in the hallway, you know, like, and someone lives there. And it's probably like, who is this obnoxious person outside no. my door? So I told Hunter that, and I was like, Hunt, like, we got to go over there. We have to go over there and say hello.
Yeah.
You know, like, this is crazy that, like, we've lived here for almost a year and we never
see her.
We never yeah. see her. So that means she's probably so lonely in her
right.
apartment.
Bring yeah. her some flowers or
yeah.
something.
Well, yeah. Bought her a pie.
Oh.
We're going
oh, you,
really old-fashioned.
Oh, so you did. I was going to say, so when are you going to meet her? You
yeah.
have.
Oh, you already have.
No. I'm going to bring it to her tomorrow.
Oh, got it. Okay.
Yeah, I'll keep
maybe
you updated.
Maybe the cauliflower pizza, too? Just kidding.
Yeah. Smuggle some
make
in my purse.
Make that tonight.
Yeah.
Just, you know, get that ready.
That's not going to last out the door.
Hunter will like it when he
cook it,
that's
going in your mouth. Yeah, Hunter, that's right up Hunter's alley.
Oh. So. This is the lesson from Lexi Pence. Say hi to your neighbors.
Say hi to your neighbor.
Just, you know, go shake their hand.
It's so easy.
It is.
It's so easy.
It is. Neighbors
and
can be your best friends.
Offer water when people come over. That's my other thing.
I agree.
And ask if it's a no shoe household.
I always assume now it's no shoes. Just FYI.
Yeah. Hmm. I mean, I always do too. I go, oh, do you want me to take off my shoes?
Right.
And then someone will say like yes or no.
Right.
But I'm the same way. But
I just
a lot
assume.
Of people don't do it and don't offer water. And I mean to everyone, like
right.
people that come in to like fix your refrigerator, people that come in
especially
to,
like, people that are working.
Yeah.
That's a good Seinfeld. Call. Anyways.
Yeah, I know. That,
the
it really
Snapple.
Is. It really is. Yes.
Alexi, anything else you want to plug or talk about before we
no,
eat
still,
more food?
I know. And so good. No, I'm just working away on my YouTube channel, youtube.com/ Let's Get Lexi, LetsGetLexi.
Cool.
And that's it, really. You know, just doing my thing.
Cool.
Yeah. Thanks.
Working it.
Yeah.
Thank you so
much
for stopping by.
Oh, my gosh. My pleasure. Anytime.
I was kind of hoping you were going to be here. I'm like, I think maybe Alexi won't be here. There
I
you
had no
were.
Idea you were going to be here.
There you were, girl.
Yeah. You should text me and tell me you were coming.
Oh, yeah. I forgot I have your number.
Yeah.
The last time I texted you was when I think Hunter walked up to my boo.
Oh,
earlier.
Yeah.
Like last year.
She
I was
told
so,
me about that,
oh,
too.
I told everyone that story. I told you that story this weekend.
Because we danced to my boo
oh,
this
that's
weekend.
That's a great song.
Yeah.
It's one of the best songs ever.
Almost our first dance song.
I wish it
oh,
was.
On acapella ukulele.
Oh, I need to
she
learn
plays,
this.
She plays.
Oh, you
ukulele.
Do?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. You need to follow
you
Melvin
can hire
sings.
Me for that. Wait, what is it?
Melvin Sings on YouTube.
Yeah.
And he does it. He does such a great rendition of it.
What?
It's so good.
Oh, my God. I'm going to learn that as soon as I get home.
Yes.
So, okay, so what ended up being your first dance song before you go?
It's called Honestly. Do you know it? It's
by who?
It's by a Hawaiian.
Oh.
But I
like it. You have that Hawaiian vibe anyway.
It's like some crazy name that he has.
Yeah.
But it's a beautiful song. He wrote it for his wife.
Oh.
And when Hunter and I heard it, we were like, yeah, this is it.
That's it.
This is it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And the way Melvin sings it, like, just brings you to tears.
Maybe we'll start or end the show with that song. This one.
Oh.
So there you go.
Perfect.
So everyone will know what you're talking about.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you so much for being on Bitch Talk. We're going to let you go eat and mingle, and we'll see you maybe in 2018.
Yes, please.
In awesome. Just a few months.
Yeah, I'm in. Just let me know.
Maybe we'll just come to the coffee shop and say hi. So
I would love that. You guys
we'll podcast from there.
More than welcome. A cup of coffee on me.
Yes.
Yes. Thanks, Lexi. Thank you, guys.
You guys, it's a warm night in San Francisco.
Very warm.
We are in SoMa,
I guess. It's not warm. It's hot. I got an Amber Alert today that said...
Oh, multiple.
That
yeah.
said, make sure to help your neighbors if they're too hot. First of all, only in San Francisco is the Amber Alert, it's very hot, and help your neighbors.
It wasn't an Amber Alert.
It felt like
an emergency. It. Amber Alert is when a child goes missing.
Okay. Same vibration.
It was along the same lines.
On your phone.
It was a little much. It was aggressive.
This wasn't even the hottest day that we've
it
had.
Was
there
not.
Were hotter days in the past few weeks. But anyway.
Oh, yeah. Like that 106
like 104 or
something.
Or whatever the fuck that was. That was insane.
We were dying. Anyways, we're here to celebrate your cookbook, Hot Mess Kitchen. By the way, been following it on Instagram for, has it been up for about a year? Been waiting. I think you and I talked about this, Gabby Moskowitz, who's been on the show before.
That's me.
Last year. So exciting. Miranda, tell us about this book.
Tell you about the book?
The book.
The book is a compilation of my essays and Gabby's essays, which introduce recipes. The recipes are all like things that would happen to you when you're living your hot mess life.
What are you talking about? I relate to way too many of them, but anyway.
Yeah, so... We want the book to be like a funny cookbook because there are a lot of funny cookbooks out there, but this is specifically like we know you're going to go through this specific situation and we're going to show you how to cook through it.
We want to make you laugh but also actually help you so the recipes are really usable.
Okay.
And I think that it is... I hate to use that thing, like, it's funny because it's true, but, like, it's funny because it's true.
What are some of the scenarios you're talking about or little notes?
Like,
if you can,
totally.
Spoiler alert.
I'm chill, but we're exclusive fish tacos. That's funny because you know exactly what we're talking about. You'd like to have a conversation with whoever you're dating and you want to move it forward, but you want them to know that, like,
you're chill.
You don't care, really. You'll see what happens.
I mean, you do.
You care.
You do care.
But you want to present that you don't care.
And fish tacos are actually like a little bit of effort. You can't just throw them together.
No.
You got to fry the fish. But, I mean, I guess you could roast the fish or steam the fish, but that's not really as good as frying the fish.
No, ever.
But still, the overall effect is very, like, chill.
Yeah.
And so it kind of works really nicely with a conversation about the status of a relationship that you're trying to keep, you know, kind of casual.
Well, fish is also kind of sexy time kind of food. Isn't
sure.
it? Fish, fishy. Yeah. Insinuation.
We're not doing that.
You're not being sexy time fish taco.
If it's a lesbian couple, I guess it's that.
You don't know who's reading this book.
Someone who likes
is so forward
fish.
About vaginas. Is like, I want my vagina to be only yours.
Yeah. I want my vagina to be only yours, fish tacos.
That's your next book, you guys.
No, I will never write that. That is for here only. Only for the internet.
Okay. In the interwebs.
That's a blog post, for sure.
How did you guys meet?
On the internet.
No, you did. What?
Yeah. We did an interview a few weeks ago, and someone made a joke like cookbook Tinder. But
cute.
That's not how we met.
Joke.
Is that your next idea? Is that what you're doing?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
definitely.
Let's do it.
How to meet your book partner without having to leave your house. We met on an app that is, by the time this podcast airs, will be no longer, but it's called List. Our friend BJ Novak started it. It's really cool, and it's like Twitter or Instagram for lists. So you could share like favorite places in San Francisco and most important things to know about making a podcast. Any sort of list that you could come up with.
Exactly.
Kind of like if BuzzFeed came to life.
And okay. That's a really good way to put it.
Thank
yeah.
you. Wow.
So I was the only food writer on, during the beta test, it was like 30 comedy writers.
There was a lot of comedy writers who were like really proud to be like, we're the comedy writers on the beta testing version of this app. I was one of those people. Okay. So I would you could request lists.
Okay.
So I would request and Gabby was posting recipes all the time in list form. So I'd request recipes from Gabby, like easiest home cooked meal to trick someone into falling in love with you. First dessert for when you're ready to sleep with someone.
And I would make the recipes.
And the right. recipes did well.
They were popular. And so we kind of got to talking and I was just joking around and I said, wouldn't it be fun if we wrote a book where you wrote the recipe or you wrote the titles and I wrote the recipes? And Miranda was like, that's actually a pretty good idea.
Yeah, there's...
It's fucking brilliant. Sorry, yes. I didn't mean to interrupt you because the titles are hilarious, and obviously we know from experience with Gabby that the recipes are awesome.
The recipes are amazing.
But I kind of feel like, sure, it's technically a cookbook, but it's also just fun to read.
Oh, totally.
And it's also sort of cathartic. It's like a self-help book. I was just flipping through.
That's what it mainly is.
When it comes
is,
to like the clean eating section,
we're
and you're talking
doctors.
About.
I'm a doc. I am.
Yeah. You're a doctor.
Oh,
you guys are
sorry.
Doctors. Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
No, that is like the thesis of it. Is that like?
It's sitting with a good friend. It's crazy.
Yeah,
I love it.
Like, cook yourself. Like, make yourself feel better by cooking.
Yeah.
Get yourself out of your hot mess.
Or you could just read it, and I mean, even not cooking it, I already feel better.
We definitely knew that there would be people who would buy the book just to read, and our hope is that if you buy it for the recipes, that you end up staying for the stories. But if you buy it for the stories, that maybe you're inspired to cook.
Yes.
So
right.
Either way, you know, you're trying out stuff.
Were you a cook before this, or are you now?
I just started to cook.
Okay.
And yeah, now I cook.
Okay. You guys, there's a really cute dog that just walked.
A cute dog walked into the room.
And yeah, that's how it started. I had started to cook, and I was so the recipes I was requesting on ListApp from Gabby were things I was genuinely curious about, which was made us realize like, oh, this is a book that like if I want these things, other girls like me will want these things, and
right.
this is something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then, so you started, I heard a little bit earlier, Gabby, that you guys started in L.A. last week. The
we were
cookbook
in L.A.
tour?
Last week.
Okay.
Doing a bunch of events and
cool.
interviews and stuff.
Yeah. And then this week is San Francisco.
This week is San Francisco. This is our last event.
Oh,
and
this
then,
is. Okay. And then where are you going to be after this?
New York.
New York. And
okay.
then D.C.
Where will you be in New York and where will you be in D.C.? Because this is going to go out tomorrow. So,
okay.
yeah.
So in New York, we are going to be at the Rizzoli Bookstore in...
It's
on
in
Broadway.
The Flatiron District.
Yeah. Ooh, okay.
On October 5th.
On October 5th. And then in D.C. on October 10th, we'll be at the East City Bookshop.
Okay.
And you can actually find all this information on hotmesscookbook.com.
There you go.
And you just click on the events tab and all the addresses and times and everything are up there.
Okay. And one more quick question because
sure.
you guys have a... huge room of people
of
for you.
We have to, I'm
yeah.
sorry. I just like we can't.
You're kind of
don't
a big
be.
Deal. Yeah. Sorry, guys, for podcasting. Anything else in the works for you two beyond the book? Or right now, is it just books?
You know what?
And we're not thinking
Stay
ahead.
Stay tuned. We are thinking ahead.
Yeah. We've been talking about maybe another book.
So, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is John Stamos in the talks of these
they
other
have a
things?
Thing for John
we have
Stamos.
A John Stamos
oh, I was,
minute.
I was like,
so.
Do you think that we know him or something?
Yeah, of course. I mean,
Hot Mess Kitchen
you
has
two
it.
Should.
Sure.
Hot
yeah,
Mess.
Uh huh. We're working on a book with John.
It's
good.
A yogurt book.
Yes.
It's all
yeah.
yogurt.
Is it all Greek yogurt?
Yes. Right.
It's all
yeah.
based.
You know, we Mindy Kaling wrote the foreword for this book, and
right.
we thought. We go in a different direction.
John's going to write the second one. We'll just put our
He's going to write
it.
The
yeah,
end.
Yeah.
I mean, you never know.
For us.
You never know.
I don't have any confidence in him writing a book in my name. I don't know him at all. That's a joke. I'm lying.
I'm willing to bet Miranda is a better writer than John Stamos.
Oh, okay. The gauntlet
Miranda's
has been
a
thrown
good
down.
Writer.
Oh, yeah.
So, like, that's
fine.
A pretty safe bet, but.
Right.
Yeah.
I don't
I agree.
Know. I don't get the feeling John Stamos is an amazing writer.
That's not his top three trait.
I don't think so. No,
he's not up on the top
same,
three.
Like haircut, is that like on purpose for photos or?
Do you know? Have you ever met Melissa King? Who she's a chef in San Francisco. She was on Top Chef.
I know
the
name.
She came in like third.
Does she have the same haircut?
She has the same haircut, but but short.
Oh, okay.
It's awesome. Like, yeah, it'd be like, it's the same sort of side.
I probably
swirl.
Follow her on Instagram.
You probably do.
It sounds familiar.
She's really amazing.
You have the, you're wearing the same outfit tonight. You're both wearing red. So from up here up, it looks great, though.
None of it was planned.
It was all planned, clearly.
It's just serendipitous.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
We think alike. So Hot Mess Kitchen is out.
It's out. Go buy it.
It's everywhere.
For the holidays.
Do yourself a favor, yeah.
For
buy it for someone you want to keep it, that's for sure.
Maybe. Buy it for the hot mess in your life. Buy it for yourself. Buy it for the friend that doesn't know they're a hot mess.
Yeah.
It's a really great first cookbook for someone who's just getting into the kitchen.
And it's a really great, or for someone who's never going to get in the kitchen, or for someone who's been in the kitchen for years
Agreed.
And wants to read a little bit.
Yeah.
Have some fun.
Maybe they should stop cooking and read for a minute.
Yeah. Duh. Stop cooking, chefs.
Stop doing your job
stop
and read.
It. Chill. Thank you so much for having us. This was fun.
Thanks for being on Bitch Talk,
ladies. This book is awesome.
Don't worry. We'll be touting this for the next few months.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Cool.
Thank you.
Awesome. I'm giving you a kiss in the microphone.
I know. I was like, is she going to go in for the kiss? Nice.
Bye. We just finished speaking with friends of the show, Lexi Pence, Gabby Moskowitz, who we've had on a few different shows, and new friend of the show, Miranda Berman. She's hella funny.
Hilarious. Yeah. I wish we had video because she's just, if it was muted and you could just look at her while she was speaking, I would start.
We're still here. We're at this really awesome, it's an event space, but I feel like it's
someone's home. It's a gallery and also her home.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Okay. So we're down in Soma. It's warm tonight. I'm sweating out the calories I'm eating.
As we've mentioned, we've been getting amber alerts.
Oh, yeah, and we're getting amber alerts because it's so hot. But it's not that. I mean, it's hot. It's not 110 degrees.
That is weird.
I think it's like, did it hit 90
you know,
even?
The three other times over the summer when it was, you know, hot as balls in town.
Yeah.
And we didn't get any of these alerts.
No.
And today was just like a warm day. And we got four of them.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. Did something happen in the past that now they think they need to increase the alerts?
Well, I think they got their ass handed to them when it was the 106-degree weather, and people are like, why didn't you put out any alerts? I don't know.
I guess.
That's my guess.
Whatever.
Anyway. But anyways, we're having a great time at the Hot Mess Kitchen book event.
This was fun inviting ourselves to this party.
I know, right? I think I should be there.
Hey, I figured Gabby's a friend of the show. She loves Bitch Talk. I appreciate that. And why not ask? That's what you got to do in life. You got to ask.
And honestly, not even just talking, this book is fucking awesome.
And she's already, I think, read the first half of the book while we're sitting here.
Well, and like they'll be talking to people in between recording, and I'm like kind of flipping through the pages because it's just so entertaining.
We're meeting some really great and interesting people. I mean, like everywhere
that
we
too.
Turn, we're meeting, eating great food, and hanging out with, you know, old friends of the show and making new friends. It's just
fun. It's not a bad night.
And we're in a beautiful space.
I mean, like I said, I want to squat here. No one can throw me out if I just squat. It's fine.
Maybe the person that lives here.
Can you squat?
Like literally, can I squat?
Yeah, all the way down, rice picker stance. Okay,
hello,
just
yoga.
Just checking.
I know I'm old, but I got it.
Nice.
I can squat. we're still here. We're having a good time.
I need to get more cauliflower crust pizza, so I want
that homemade onion dip again.
French onion dip,
I mean, that was way better than
Lipton. And the shrimp dumplings
with
scallion.
I didn't have that yet.
I've had like three.
It's probably gone at this point.
All right, let's go. No, there's still more.
Anyways, that's Bitch Talk. This is episode 221.
Got a busy week.
Oh, yeah. We have more to come, you guys. We have a live podcast from Beer Bottle Brewery. Say that five times fast. Ange thought I was lying and didn't think anyone listened to this podcast. They actually came to us, was like, oh, hey, we listened. Come down anytime. And I was all, you don't have to tell me twice. We'll be there.
You
2 weeks.
Will regret these words, sir.
Yeah, so we will be there. We're going to speak with one of the owners. His name's Mike. We're going to take a tour. They have their comedy night Thursday night, but I guess it's normally the first Mondays of the month. So go on to Bear Bottle Brewery. You can find out all their events. They also have a food truck calendar. Every day they have a food truck there, guys. So it's kid friendly. It's dog friendly. It's podcast friendly.
Bitch friendly.
Bitch talk friendly.
Yeah, it's us friendly.
So
apparently.
Be there or be smart.
Might not be after tomorrow, though, but who knows?
I mean, we may not be really all together after about 5:30, but it's fine. I mean, that's why you have Lyft on your phone. So come see us, and thanks for listening.
Bitch, please.
I love you.